Hi gun people! Oh crap, what the hell did I just do? Stupid live. So there's Mokey Cat over there. Say hi Mokey Cat! Uh-oh, what happened? Am I live? Shit, I don't know if this damn thing went public or not. I'm in my little room over here. About to, This live is for going... What are you doing? Hey, there's everybody commenting on YouTube. Hey, gun people. There's Mokey Cat down there. What are you doing, boy? Say hi to YouTubies. You're live, Mokey. Mokey, you're live. I've been working on this dead kitty. Bang. Dead cat. Bang. Hey, gun people. So, I got this new stinking internet. Or not new internet. They put in this fiber optic. Maybe some of you guys can hook me up on this because I ain't Mokey Cat. I ain't Mokey Cat. So this is just going to be a short live to see how this thing's working. How is everything? Good. Is that... Attention, Rick and everyone. Nice. Okay. Hi, Mokey Cat. Say hi. Say hi, YouTubies. So... Tomorrow, I'm going live, but I don't know how to do this scheduling thing, to do the schedule. So this will just be a short live. Tomorrow, I'm either going to do a detailed breakdown. Hang on, I got to come in here and read all my stuff. Hey, Rick. Looks like it's working good. Netherlands. Dude, I like when I get all these crazy places that I've never been to. Quebec. I had somebody from, I think, Saudi Arabia the other day. I was like, cool. So tomorrow, the question... I don't want you over here by this oil, boy. I don't want you by the oil. You say hi to YouTubies. Tomorrow, me and Mokey's going to do a video on either the 1911... You don't want to get down? Okay. Either the 1911 complete takedown or the Glock. Now, all I got is Glock 21s. I think I got a Glock 30. So I'm going to do either a good detailed live so I can get questions, show you how to break it down, completely take it apart, and then put it back together. And because I'm going to do it live, I'm going to get a close-up. I'll be able to show all the parts and pieces. I'm using an iPhone. Hopefully I got good clarity. I got to come back and read all this. Don't give me money on this thing, freaking YouTube. Nice hoodie. Yeah, one of my great little viewers. I don't know if little... Emily's out there right now. I haven't seen her. She may be online. That's a big old comment. Good grief. What does that say? Rick, thank you so much for helping me with my horses. Oh, good. I'm glad they helped. Somebody just said bye. Anyway, tomorrow, I'm going to try to do it right now. Hell, I don't even know what time it is. I'm thinking it's around 2 o'clock here in Texas. So tomorrow at about, let's schedule it for 1 p.m. tomorrow, Sunday. My time, Texas time, 1 p.m. I'll do a live. And then in the comments, you need to put either you want the 1911 complete breakdown. If you want to go kind of 1911, I got Dan Wesson. I don't have any Smiths, don't have any Sigs, but I got pretty much all the others. So in the comments, if you want to put what 1911 you'd like to see me, they're all breakdown the same, doesn't matter. And I'll do a breakdown on the 1911, completely take apart and put back together step by step. Or the Glock, which is easier and quicker. I just don't know what viewers are going to be here tomorrow, so you can decide. You have 24 hours. If you got a Glock, you want the Glock breakdown. If you want nine, and if I get 50-50, I'll do one tomorrow, and then I'll do another one on the other one. But this live makes it to where when I'm doing my live, I have a close-up, and then I can read the questions and kind of get some, you know, feedback. So I haven't been reading any of my questions here. Oh, I wanted to show you guys my little project over here, too. Hang on. How do I turn this freaking camera around? I always screw this up. If I lose you, I hit the wrong button. Oh, there we go. So I put in this little, I love my little lights now in my closets. So I put in a light socket, and now when I open a closet, it's always been dark. And now, oh, the light's still on. Shit, I can't show you. It stays on for 10 minutes. You won't see it come on. I want you to see it come on because it's pretty cool. Where'd that crazy cat go? I got this. This is my junk room, so I'm kind of flashing around. Everybody will be like, what's that? What's that? I'll give you a little flash. Just, woo, what was that? Woo, Woo, what was that? Woo, what was that? Woo, a little scared. Woo, Rick, don't move it fast. It's too fast. You get, all right, let's see. Let's see. 1911. Glock, then do a second one on the 1911. Okay. Well, I'll read all the comments tomorrow before I set it up. And we'll do either one. I don't know which one I'm going to do. I like it when I'm not in the camera because then I can just film something and I can read all the comments. Clean your room. No, this is, I do need to clean it up, but it's a project for later. Moki, are you rubbing on that boy? Let's see here. See, when I'm filming on the other way, I can read. Glock, California, man, you're in Commieville. You're behind enemy lines over there, let me tell you. What do you think of the weather? I know it's like 61, 62, it's freaking hot. And out in the wind, it's pretty chilly, so I had a little sweatshirt on out there goofing around feeding horses. Did I say, hey, say horse people or someone else saying hi? I might have said, hey, horse people. Glock is way easy. I agree, but if you're new to Glocks and you've never taken apart the trigger and you've pulled out the firing pin and to put it back, there's a couple little tricks and gimmicks for, you know, the magazine release and all that. But, I mean, the 1911 is definitely more complicated. I will give you that. Let's see. You guys can look over here. Somebody sent me some bottles, then I ordered some little bottles. So I just put a little piece of wood and I hammered it to the bottom of the table there, screwed it in, and now I've got all my little oils in my little thing. Go juice, 3-in-1. And that way when I need a drop, I've got it right there instead of having all those trying to find which one is which. Somebody asked me about that picture. This was just kind of like a, I forgot where I got that. I think some guys gave it to me just as a cop joke because Barney Fife was always, even cops joke about Barney Fife, about he was the last cop in Great Citizen's Arrest. And on the back, it shows him, I'll pull it down and show you guys because I get a lot of questions on that.
Oh, shit! Damn it! I think I just broke it.
Okay, it didn't break. Cool. Okay. So, this was a picture, and it kind of explains, looks like I'm getting some reflection from some light here. Let me move over here. So, this is on the front, and then it shows on the set, and then there's Barney Fife, and then on the back, I think it's signed. And he did a book signing or something, or he's signing these little pictures. So, this is the Barney Fife picture that everybody's always asking about. Oh, my light went off. All right. So let me go back and do my little light thing. This live shit's crazy. The only thing is I can't edit it, cut it out. You guys are seeing shit. Okay, so here's what happens when I open my closet now. I freaking love this. All you women will be getting your husbands to do this. Motion sensor light. It's always dark. Not anymore. When you walk in, the big light comes on. Yeehaw! So this light has a sensor on a movement, and when you open it, I don't want to show you everything in a closet. It's a pretty big closet. So I just put that little light socket in there. I ran that. I actually ran that one from this one right here. Just poked a hole and ran a wire back there. Oh, I don't know what happened there. And then, so I put that thing in there, and then I just ran the wire up. I haven't really connected a wire and ran it in the corner and held it. But I love it now. So now when I open my closets, I don't have to worry about the light, and I don't have to worry about turning it off, because as soon as I close it, it goes off automatically. All right, so tomorrow's the deal. Put in the comments 1911 or Glock, and we'll go through the whole list. And I won't be moving around tomorrow. I'll just have it right here where I'm working on a gun, and I can read the comments, and we'll just go through piece by piece on either Glock or 1911. And, you know, I'm sure we'll talk about other shit that comes up in the comments. So anyway, thanks for coming. It says I'm live for 19 minutes. This damn fiber optic shit. Oh yeah, I forgot to ask that. On fiber optic, one of you internet nerds out there with a little propeller head who understands all this 4 gig, 6 gig, 5 gig, Ethernet, gigabyte, whatever. So this internet, I'm supposed to be getting 50 download and 25 upload. Freaking, I'm only getting like 40 download and like 22. And the guy goes, oh, well, that's because you're on wireless. We only guarantee the 50 and 25 when you're hooked up hardline. So obviously I can't hardline. Most of my house is wireless. And I'm like, man, that doesn't sound right. I should be able to buy it better. They gave me, I forgot the name of the server. Some Calx or something. I looked it up. It's like a $200 server. And it's supposed to guarantee speed. But it's a pain in the butt. And then I don't get very good connections. So I need to get an extender. Because they put the damn thing up in a corner of the house. Because it was easy. Instead of back in the middle where it was. So I'm going to call and fight with them tomorrow. But if I get a different, when I was looking at routers, some of them have a 2 gig processor, this and that. Does that change speed? Or is the reason I'm losing so much? Because now they dialed me up. They go, we'll give you the weekend. They dialed me up to 100 download and 50 upload. And when I'm downstairs, I do a speed test and I'm at 52 download and like 30 upload. And I'm supposed to be at 150 upload. So I'm like, dude, either your router sucks, either my equipment sucks. I should not be losing. I wasn't losing that much when I had DSL. It said 5 and 1. I had 5 download and 1 upload. And I have seen absolutely zero speed difference when I upload a video. However, I can go live. I couldn't go live before. So anyway, answer that in the comments if you don't mind. You're on Think Like a Horse. Am I on Think Like a Horse? Are you serious? I went on the wrong freaking channel. I'm talking to all my gun people. Think Like a Horse, Rick. People are trying. Oh, my God. What the? Maybe I can copy this. What the stupid-ass YouTube iPhone shit? Screw me. Damn. No wonder. I was like, damn, I got a lot of horse people on my gun channel. Shit. Damn. Stupid technology. Well, shit. Now I don't know how do I get this on my damn horse or my gun channel? Damn, I went live last time on my horse channel out in the park, out in the pasture. So it must have stayed. I forgot to switch. All right. I'll try and figure out how to post this on my stupid gun channel. Hi, horsey people. Mr. D and Buddy, I just gave... Buddy's been bucking and acting like a fool. But anyway, I'll... Shit. What a dumbass. Damn it, it's Moki's fault. He was playing around with the damn iPhone. He probably switched it. I'm going to go beat that cat. All right, horsey people, sorry. Sorry to bug you about gun shit. They're like, what the hell are you talking about? Damn. All right, let me end this and see if I can copy this to freaking my gun channel. All right, see y'all. Thanks for coming for crazy wrong channel. I know how to stop it now. I hit the X and I go, bye-bye.